Insulation. First, ensure the deck is clean and free of moisture, debris, frost, deteriorated decking, or other conditions detrimental to the performance of the insulation. All joints must be staggered a minimum of 12 inches. If starting the first course with a full sheet, start the second course with a half sheet, the third course with a full sheet, and so on, repeating this pattern. If multiple layers are installed, ensure joints are staggered between layers as well to prevent thermal bridging. There are several attachment options, including low-rise adhesives, hot asphalt, and plates and fasteners. The deck type often determines the optimum attachment method. This video depicts mechanical attachment only. Fasteners must be used with 3-inch stress plates. 2.4-inch barbed seam plates are not acceptable for insulation attachment. The fastening pattern to use is determined by the system type, insulation type and thickness, and deck type and thickness. Fully adhered systems generally require more insulation fasteners than mechanically attached systems. The fastener pattern is important. Building height, wind uplift requirements, deck type and thickness, and insulation type and thickness will determine the fastening pattern to follow. On fully adhered projects, additional fasteners are required in the perimeters and corners. Mulehide requires 50% more fasteners in the perimeter and 100% more fasteners in the corners. On non-factory mutual projects, Mulehide's minimum perimeter and corner dimension is 8 feet. Insulation fasteners in a mechanically attached system do not affect wind uplift performance of the system, so fewer insulation fasteners can be used. Mulehide requires 6 fasteners per 4x8 board on insulation less than 2 inches thick, or 5 fasteners per board on insulations 2 inches thick or more, regardless of the uplift requirements. Increased fastening in the perimeters and corners is not required in a mechanically attached system.